Hi, my name is Katie Kniep, and I'm a senior customer loyalty lead on the platforms team at Google, assisting with creating operational scale and enhancing the customer support experience. I've been in the programmatic advertising space for over 5 years, and today I will be walking you through the basics of how to navigate Display and Video 360, often referred to as DV360. As you may already know, DV360 is our demand-side platform, or DSP, offering within Google Marketing Platform that helps creative, data, and media teams work together to execute end-to-end campaigns. Some of DV360's key benefits include premium programmatic guaranteed offerings, access to audiences powered by Google data, and the ability to tap into Google-owned and operated inventory. If you're new to the DV360 product and would like to learn more about its benefits and capabilities, we recommend first watching the video linked in the description box below. Let's first take a look at how accounts are structured in DV360. The easiest way to think about it is in terms of a hierarchy. Starting at the highest level in DV360, we have the partner level. This could be a specific agency, or it could also be a specific brand if you have multiple advertisers underneath. For example, a brand that has local or co-op initiatives. One step below that, we have the advertiser level, which is typically a specific advertiser within the given agency or brand. At this level, you'll also have easy access to the 5 main modules of DV360, which we will walk through later on in this video. Moving down to the campaign level, this is generally used to break out different seasonal strategies. For example, an advertiser may set up specific campaigns around the holidays or for seasonal shoe launches. Next up, we have the insertion order level, sometimes referred to as IO, which can be used to segment out different strategic formats, such as display, video, or native. And finally, we arrive at the lowest level in DV360, the line item level, or LI, which is where you can break out the most granular targeting strategies. Great, now let's navigate over to DV360 to walk through these different levels. So here we are at the partner level. Let's start with some quick navigation basics. At the top right of the screen, you'll see a toolbar that is accessible throughout all levels of the platform. Some tools to quickly take note of are the search icon, which allows you to easily search for your advertisers, campaigns, etc. Next, we have the question mark icon, which allows you to quickly search through Help Center articles. And if you scroll all the way down, you will also see an option to contact one of our support specialists if you have more specific questions or concerns. And then finally, we have the Switch Products icon, which allows you to conveniently switch between the different products within Google Marketing Platform. Now, if we scroll over to the left-hand sidebar, you'll find a list of tabs that allow you to quickly navigate to relevant modules of the platform, such as the audiences or inventory modules. We'll explore some of these in more detail once we reach the advertiser level. Towards the center of the screen, you'll see automated charts that showcase key performance indicators, such as budget and pacing. And just below that, you will see a list of all of the advertisers within the partner that you have access to, which you can easily sort through using the filter icon to the right. Moving to the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see an intelligence panel, which displays alerts and suggestions to help you optimize campaign performance. This can be especially helpful to reference if you're managing multiple advertisers or campaigns simultaneously. Great, let's now move one level down on the hierarchy to the advertiser level by clicking into one of these advertisers. As you can see, the layout remains essentially the same, and the left-hand sidebar has expanded slightly to showcase the 5 main integrated modules of DV360 that work together to simplify campaign management. Let's quickly walk through these, starting with the campaigns module. This is where you can build and execute cross-channel media plans. Within this module, you can create, optimize, and monitor campaigns and insertion orders. Now let's move on to the audiences module, which offers the ability to manage, build, and analyze a wide range of audiences so that you can plan and implement audience strategies with ease. Let's take a look at the all audiences option to start. At the top, you will see 3 different tabs, starting with general. Within this tab, you can easily search for and view audiences that already exist within the advertiser, And you can also create new first-party, third-party, or combined audiences. Next up, we have the Custom List tab. Here you can tap into DV360's special audience offerings, such as Custom Affinity and Custom Intent, that are powered by Google properties and aim to provide a holistic view of user behavior. Finally, we have the Combined tab, where you can create custom combinations between your first-party, Google data, and/or third-party lists to fit your advertiser needs. Now let's take a quick look at the Analysis tab. Here you can uncover insights about your audiences and also find new audiences that may provide incremental reach on your campaigns. Moving on to the third module, we have Creatives. Here's where you will tie your creative strategy to your data and media plan. For example, within the Creatives tab, you can easily manage and search for existing creatives within the advertiser. You can also click into creatives to see more specific details, such as assets and creative status. Going back to the full creatives view, here you can also upload new creatives such as image, YouTube, audio, etc., as well as any third-party creatives. And then if we shift down to the Format Gallery tab, here's where you can discover, design, and build high-impact custom creatives. As you can see, there are many different types of creatives available, ranging from standard banners to custom high-impact formats to in-stream video to native. And this really allows you to select different creative types to best align with your overall strategy and campaign goals. Next up, we have the Inventory module. For example, within the My Inventory tab, you can easily manage all of your publisher deals and inventory packages. Moving down to the Marketplace tab, you can think of this kind of like a storefront where you can discover new deals and publishers that fit your advertising goals. Also, by clicking into a specific publisher, such as Hulu, you can also see the breakdown of forecasted reach, demographic information, and devices. And then finally, we have the Insights module, where you can pull all of your media metrics through either instant or offline reporting to evaluate campaign performance, identify what inventory and audiences may be popping for your brands, and ultimately use that data to make informed optimizations. Let's move down an additional level on the DV360 hierarchy to the campaign level by navigating back to the campaign module and clicking into one of the campaigns. As mentioned earlier, campaigns are often used to group together insertion orders with common business goals. Some of the most useful features at this level are, first off, the access to automated charts and unique views across the combined insertion orders and line items tabs that help you track your campaign goals. And then if we navigate over to the campaign settings tab on the left-hand side, here's where you can set frequency caps and any other default targeting across multiple insertion orders. Now let's shift one level down to the insertion order level. Within this line items tab, you'll be able to see a list of the different line items within the insertion order. Then, if we shift over to the Insertion Order Details tab, you'll be able to edit and view settings such as allocated budget, pacing, goals, and any other default targeting. Finally, let's move down to the lowest level of the DV360 hierarchy, the line item level. Within this main tab, you can apply more granular targeting such as inventory, audience lists, and performance goals. And then if you scroll towards the bottom, you can also select and view your assigned creatives. Now shifting our view to the right-hand side of the screen, you'll also see an intelligence panel for line item reach. These estimates will give you quick visibility into how your line item could perform based on your applied targeting and budget settings. One other feature I'd like to direct your attention to is the Troubleshooter tab. This is a powerful, easy-to-use tool to utilize anytime you're facing issues with delivery. It will give you a quick glance into what could be inhibiting spend or scale so that you can take action accordingly. All right, you should now be familiar with how to navigate Display and Video 360. For a deeper dive on DV360's capabilities, please reference the additional videos linked below, and feel free to reach out to your Google rep or platform specialist with any questions. Thanks for watching.